and you look to me like we're ready now for another referendum campaign. We have to go for it. We have to go for it. We need our Parliament to use the mandate they were given to call another referendum campaign in the lifetime of this Parliament. And we have to do it because Westminster has demonstrated... I think I'm going to let them go past. The longer it takes, the better, because the more of them there are. Let's get going. Westminster has demonstrated its contempt for Scotland. We have seen the Parliament of the United Kingdom pass a government amendment which states that consent from the Scottish Parliament can equal a vote not to consent in the Scottish Parliament. We have seen a judgment from the London Supreme Court that says that the government in Westminster can override any act of the Scottish Parliament on any subject. The truth is this, we have no chance of any acceptable devolution settlement within the United Kingdom. Westminster is zero, nothing. Westminster should never have any of my... money into the great financial cesspit of London, and we have had enough of it. They spend our taxation on weapons of mass destruction and then force us to house them there because they don't want them near London. And we have had enough of WMD in Scotland. They use our taxation and they use our children as soldiers to fight and wage illegal wars. And just this last month, we have seen another illegal attack, an illegal bombing and missile raid on Syria by British armed forces. And we have had enough of Westminster's war. We do not want another Cold War. We do not want all this wasteful defence spending. Russia is not Scotland's enemy. Scotland has no enemies. Allow me to quote the great James Connolly, born in the Cowgate in Edinburgh, who said, "They say we should unite to face the foreign enemy. I know of no enemy but the British government." And the British government is the enemy, not just of the Scottish people, it's the enemy of the English people, the Welsh people, the Irish people, the Cornish people, all of those who suffer from the austerity and viciousness of these Tory governments. We have to move, we have to act. The time is now. During the last independence referendum campaign, we moved up from 32% to 45%. During the next campaign, we will move up from 45% to 60%. But we won't do it till the campaign starts. We must stop shilly-shallying, and we must start now.
Thanks for your stoicism while events were going past. Craig's at the whole of the British Empire trying to shut him down and clamp him. Like, the whole of the press and the government and everything. It'd take more than a few bikers to phase him. Okay, next up we're going to have some music for you. Thanks for listening to those speakers. We're going to have a few more good speakers up later on. A lot of Esther Ladders. We've got someone from the Catalan National Assembly coming as well. But now, a guy for the Kingdom of Fife now plays his trade in Edinburgh. If you're ever in Edinburgh, go to the Royal Oak, see him doing his stuff. Hey, buy his CDs, he's probably got some CDs with him.